April 28th, 2015 Planning Commission regular meeting to order at 6:30 p.m. Please stand if you are able, and Commissioner Iglesias will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Amend and adopt the agenda. Are there any changes to the agenda? If not, I make a motion to adopt the agenda as presented. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Any discussion? All in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. Review of meeting procedures, Ms. Goldman. Sorry.
Welcome to the Forsyth County Planning Commission meeting. We would like to take a few minutes to cover the procedures of the meeting for those of you not familiar with them. For all public hearings, the Planning Commission will allow 10 minutes per side, not 10 minutes per speaker. Please only request to speak if you have something new to add. Following the opening of the public hearing, the applicant or authorized representative shall have the opportunity to present. Then any persons in opposition shall have the opportunity to present. Finally, the presiding officer may provide the applicant or authorized representative time for rebuttal. Please refrain from disrupting the meeting through general outbursts, applause, or comments from the audience, and please be courteous of others with the use of cell phones. Anyone wishing to productively contribute is welcome to speak during the public hearing. The public is reminded, however, that the purpose of the public hearing is to obtain or offer information related to the applications presented to the Planning Commission. All comments should be focused on the application being heard by the Commission. Speakers should address their comments to the merits of the application and should not make or direct personal comments toward elected or appointed officials or county staff. Speakers should not seek to engage in a discussion with the Planning Commission unless responding to a question put directly to the speaker by the Commission. Anyone speaking at the public hearing is required to complete a public hearing speaker sign-in sheet and shall give this sheet to staff before approaching the podium. These sheets are available as you enter the meeting room or from our staff. Please note that any person wishing to speak in opposition of a rezoning action who has provided campaign contributions to any Forsyth County elected official in aggregation of $250 or more dollars within 2 years immediately preceding the filing of the rezoning action is required to file the public hearing speaker sign-in sheet at least 5 calendar days prior to the public hearing. Once you reach the podium, please state your name. All information submitted by the applicant or opposition shall be presented to the staff, not tendered directly to the Planning Commission members. Information shall then be circulated to the board members with one copy retained by the Department of Planning and Community Development as part of the permanent record. The Department of Planning and Community Development is open Monday through Friday from 8:30 till 5. Additional information on cases heard tonight can be found on the Forsyth County website. The recommendations of this meeting will be heard at the Board of Commissioners meeting on May 21st, 2015.
Thank you, Ms. Goldman. Motion to consider adoption of minutes for the March 24th, 2015 regular meeting and the April 21st, 2015 work session meeting. You know, you were absent on the board. I make a motion to adopt the minutes for the March 24th, 2015 regular meeting. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Dolezal. Does staff have any changes to these minutes?
No changes.
Thank you. Is there any discussion? All in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 3-0 with Commissioner Iglesias being abstained because she was absent from that meeting and Commissioner Neal being absent. I make a motion to adopt the minutes for the April 21st, 2015 work session. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Does staff have any changes to these minutes?
No changes.
Thank you. Is there any discussion? All in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. Old business, there is none. New business, there is none. Public hearings for conditional use permits, there are none. Public hearings for home occupation permits, there are none. Public hearings for rezonings, 3D project management, David Gay, ZA3715. Ms. Goldman.
This is a request to rezone from Agricultural District A1 and Commercial Business District CBD to Agricultural District A1 on 9 acres with a conditional use permit for a proposed 31,609 square foot church with 181 parking spaces. This property is located at 5455 Campground Road, Cumming, Georgia, 30040, and on the west side of Campground Road, approximately 600 feet north of the intersection with Atlanta Highway. Staff is supportive.
Thank you. I make a motion to open the public hearing for 3D project management, David Gay, ZA3715. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Hoyt. Any discussion? All in favor of the motion to open the public hearing, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. Is there anyone wishing to speak in favor of 3D project management, David Gay, ZA3715? No?
I can, but.
Yes, too.
I mean, I'm the applicant.
Come on up.
I'll be best if you settle also about the project. State your name first, please.
I'm David Gay, 3D Project Management. Wishing to make application for the rezoning of 9 acres from I-2 A1 zoning. I'm actually a project manager working on behalf of Christ Community Church. The current property is actually a total of 9 acres. There's currently 3 acres that is zoned CBD, 6 acres that is zoned A1. We're actually going to combine both parcels to the A1 zoning for a future building project.
And you have to get a conditional use.
Correct.
You have to request a conditional use permit to do that.
For church.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Is there anyone else wishing to speak in favor? Is there anyone wishing to speak in opposition? I make a motion to close the public hearing for 3D project management, David Gay, ZA3715. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Hoyt. Is there any discussion? All in favor of the motion to close the public hearing, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. Does the Planning Commission have any questions of the applicant? No? Commissioner Dolezal, this is District 3. Are you prepared to make a motion for a recommendation?
I am, Madam Chair. I make a motion to rescind ZA3715 3D Project Management, David Gay, to the Board of Commissioners with a recommendation to approve as Agricultural District A1 with conditions as shown on the screen.
have a question.
Actually, before we move past the motion, don't we, there was reference to the requested cup as well. Is that you're doing a separate, or are you including that?
I'm going to include that in the motion to the requested cup.
Second. Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Is there any discussion?
Yes, I have a question. I'm looking on the second page where you're discussing food service and it not prohibiting food services provided only to the congregation. I know a lot of churches have church festivals. There's the Greek festival, there's the Red Door festival, there's, you know, every church has a festival once or twice a year. And I would hope that this would be worded where it would be broad enough to apply to when people are coming for a church festival. And I'm not making an amendment at this time, but I'm just suggesting that maybe that could say to the congregation or for church activities or something broad enough to include that.
Tom, do you have any thoughts on that? These were conditions we applied to a recent similar application.
Right.
I don't know how you would interpret
it. And I may not have thought of it at that time. In fact, I didn't think of it at that time. But just looking at this, if it says that the restaurant, coffee shop, or food services with products available for sale to the public, provided this condition will not prohibit food services provided only to the congregation. Maybe I should ask Mr. Brown how in church conditional use permits, church festivals are dealt with where there's a temporary food service situation and things going on the grounds. Would we need to make this condition looser to allow for that sort of activity?
I would recommend loosen this condition if that's the intent to allow that.
I would, if I may make a proposed amendment, I would, in number five, unnumbered bullet point that begins restaurant, coffee shop, or food service, where it says services provided only to the congregation or in connection with church festival activities at which the public is invited.
Church activities.
Church activities where the public is invited.
Second.
We have a motion and a second for an amendment. Is there any discussion? All those in favor of the amendment, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? The amendment motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. We're now back to the main amended motion. We have a main amended motion and a second. Is there any discussion? All in favor of the amended motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. Make a motion to adjourn the April 28, 2015 regular meeting and public hearing. May I have a second?
We all second.
Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Any discussion? All in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion to adjourn passes 4-0 with Commissioner Neal being absent. We are adjourned at 6:44 p.m.